converts, المتحولون من دين إلى دين. Then I discovered that many years later that these converts, they started asking us, please don't call us converts, call us reverts. The convert is the one who changed from something to something. Okay? He was in this direction, then he decided to go to that direction. The revert is the one who was going in a direction, then he decided, discovered that he must go back to the original pure status. Back. I was in astray, or I was lost, so I go back to the truthness. So that's why they started saying, please, we are reverts, not converts. This led me to think how Allah guided them to choose the right terminology. This because they understood the concept, Allahu A'lam, of the meaning of Hadith Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, where he says, كل مولود يولد على الفطرة فأبواه يهودانه أو ينصرانه أو يمجسانه. Now, the word fitrah, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, everyone is born on fitrah. Now, the fitrah can be translated in different ways. Fitrah, you can say, the original pure status as Allah creates us when we are in our pure status. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, everyone is born on fitrah, which means in a pure status. His parents later will make him, and as an example, he gave three examples, a Jew, or a Christian, or a Zoroastrian. But he did not say his parents will make him a Muslim, because originally he is a Muslim. So fitrah in this hadith is equal to Islam. As if the hadith is suggesting or telling that by default we are born Muslims. In terms of what? By default, we are designed from in our inner nature, i.e. fitrah, that by default we know, we feel comfortable that Allah is one. Anything else, it's outside the fitrah. That there is a hereafter. That drinking alcohol is wrong by fitrah. Adultery is wrong by fitrah. Pedophilia is wrong by fitrah. Homosexuality is wrong by fitrah. See? So when I'm out, I need someone to bring me back to the fitrah. So in my language, when we say fitrah, it's the basic minimum requirement of the divine system that we are born with. It's walillahi al-mathal al-a'la, just to make it simple. It's like having the operating system like the Windows. So when you have a computer, okay, operating system is the Windows. You can't bring the office if you don't have the Windows. The Windows basically is a program. It is a software, but it's to run the hardware. But you need the Adobe family, you need the office, you need the Word, you need the PowerPoint, you need later on to operate, you know, with the maximum, you know, needs. But even if you bring the PowerPoint or the Word, if you don't have the Windows, you can do nothing. Because there is no operating system. Now the filter is the operating system. It comes by the manufacturer, but it's the basic minimum requirement to operate. Then you need the full other softwares. Other softwares, the revelation. The final version of the software is the Quran. The added, external, authentic version from the same manufacturer. When you have the two, they are compatible. You will have the best capacity of performance. It's just, you know why I'm highlighting this? It's from one angle, to be proud of your religion. That you have the original pure status. Then, when you speak about your religion, please let these meanings prevail and be clear in the minds of the people when you talk about your religion. Be proud that you have the original copy of the manufacturer, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى, which is, you know, from Allah, and we are born according to the system, and we have the last authentic copy, which is Islam, and it's compatible with the original pure status, which is Fitrah. If this is clear, by the way, you yourself, you should be proud. Feel it, let others know it. Jazakum Allah khair, barakallahu feekum. Salaam alaykum.